Now, declaring a multidimensional array, as I told you in the previous video, in Java is a lot different than declaring the multidimensional array in C and C++, because the memory is allocated very differently. So, as I think you have already followed my videos on C language, where I told you that when you allocate a memory to an array, in there is a two-dimensional or three-dimensional array in C language. Now, that memory is allocated in a row major order in C language, but in languages like Fortran, that memory is allocated in a column major order. Now, here, as you can see, if I declare integer double brackets here, a is equal to new int 3 comma 2, okay? So, here 3 is actually by logics, it says this is the number of rows and this is the number of columns, but how the memory will be allocated will be like this, that will be having 3 rows. This is a single dimensional array here, and here if for the single dimensional array will be having 3 more single dimensional arrays. So, this is done because as I told you that in arrays here they are the objects. Okay, so it leads to better memory utilization in Java. Now, you can also declare a two-dimensional array where every dimension will be having different sizes. For example, here I am creating a two-dimensional array. So, this is declaration, this is creating an object. Okay, it specifies that we are going to have 4 rows here, and for every row, for example, a of 0, that means for this row, I am creating new int of 1, that means it is pointing to an one-dimensional array which is having again one index location. So, this is a two-dimensional array, and where every location here is pointing to again one-dimensional array or two-dimensional array like this. Okay. So, if I do a of 1, then it is new int of 2, that is this will be pointing to a location which is having two locations here. Again, a of 2, that is for the second index location I am creating new int of 2, again it will be pointing to a one-dimensional array which is having two locations. And when I am doing a of 3, which is new int of 3, so again it is pointing to a one-dimensional array which is having 3 locations. Okay, so this is actually again two-dimensional array where for every row we are having a different number of columns. So, if you represent it graphically or the way we represent in C language, so you can say that here we are having 4 rows, so 1, 0, 1, 2, and 3. Graphically it should have 4 rows. In the first row we are having only one items here, in the second row we are having 2 items, in the third row again we are having 2 items, in the fourth row we are having 3 items like this. Okay, so this is how this array is declared. Okay, now if I give you some locations here, so if I give you an array like this, can you declare this array, I mean can you initialize or allocate memory to this array? So you can see this is again a 3 dimensional array. Okay, so this is the first dimension, this is the second dimension, this is the third dimension like this. So how will you declare this? For creating a structure like this, structure of an array like this, I have to do integer a, which is the name of this array, which is having 3 dimensions, and I have to create new integer. Now I have to create 3 dimensions here. So what is the number of you can say rows here, so blocks, or you can say, so that will be 4. Okay, now for every location we have to declare one. Okay, for this also we have to create different structure. So what I can do is a of 0 is equal to, as you can see, this is for this a of 0 means I am just referring to this location. Okay, now for this location I have to create this one, so I am going to create new integer with 2 locations. This is 0th and 1st, and I have not specified the size of this level. So then what I have to do is a of this location is 0 and 0. So a of 0, 0 is equal to new int with 1 location, and then a of 0 and 1 is equal to new int with 2 locations. Okay, so 0, 1 means 0, 1, and here I am giving an array of 2 locations here. Okay, now for this one again you can do the same, so you can do a of 1, so for this first index location I am creating this one, so I am going to create new integer with 3 locations here, and I am not specifying the size of this location. So what I can do again is a of 1 0, 1, 0 means 1, and this is the 0th index location here. I'm going to give new integer of one location. And again, after this, to create this, I can do a of 1, 1. Okay, 1, 1, and here I'm going to allocate memory for this, that is new integer of two locations. Again, 1, 2, right? A of 1 and 2. Here I have to allocate three locations, so new integer for three locations. Okay, and then for this also I can create the same. So I can do A of 2, that means for this second location, again for this also I can create some different structure like this. Again, I can create new integer. It is having two locations. So with the two locations, and I'm not specifying the size of these locations. Further, you can create A of 2, 0 is equal to new integer with four locations. Again, A of 2, 1, which is new integer with one location. Okay. So this is how you can also create a structure, an array structure, which is a multidimensional array. It is again a three-dimensional array. All the three-dimensional array, whether it's a two-dimensional array, whether it's a four-dimensional array, any dimensions of arrays in Java is actually implemented by using one-dimensional arrays only. Okay, so you can clearly see that because for every case we are going to create some objects here. So this is an object, this is a separate object, this is an object, this is an object, this is an object, this is also every one of them will be having an object, and for every one of them they will be having their member methods, or you can say the member functions. Okay, so I just showed you how the memory is allocated to the multidimensional arrays here, but let me continue with this series and let me discuss more about multidimensional array. That means how you can declare, what are the some of the member functions that are available, and there's so many things that we have to discuss. Okay, so let me rub it up and let me come back after this.